Good day, learners. This is your Learn at Home program. My name is Haruna Manate Yerima, and I'll be taking in agricultural science. The topic we have today is wheat. We want to discuss wheat in our lesson today. We have been following our parents to farm. They have been working, we have been seeing them. Some of us, we may not have parents that are going to farm, maybe our parents are civil servants, but along the line, there are various homes, they have what we call garden. Or in the school, we have what we call garden. Sometimes they'll go there and plant crops, and later you see them carrying hoe, going back to that farm again. You discover that as they are going back to the farm with the hoes, what they normally do is to remove the grasses. Some grasses there or plants in that farm. Have you ever taken your time to ask them why are they removing those grasses or the plants? The reason being that those plants were not planted by them. And they become what? Weeds. Then, let's look at the meaning of weeds. By definition, weeds can be defined in the following ways. Either of the ways you can define weed. One, we say a weed is any uncultivated plant that grows among cultivated ones. Yes, if you are going to a farm, you have planted your crops, along the line you discover that maybe as a result of previous crops that you have planted in that farm, some crops will germinate alongside with the one you have planted this year. Then, that is why we say they grow among the uncultivated crops growing among the cultivated ones. The second definition says, a weed is any plant which grows in a place where it is not expected to grow or where it is not wanted. Yes, it might be a crop, but because you don't want it to grow in that place that it is, it becomes a weed. Then the third one says, a weed is a plant that grows where it is not desired in such a way that it constitutes nuisance either to man, livestock, or crops. Yes, nuisance in the sense that, you see the crops, the reason why we're removing them because they compete in terms of nutrient with the crops we're planted. So there is a need for you to remove them in order not to compete with the nutrient that the crop will be using in that farm. And another thing is space. They cannot allow the plant to get enough air that will enable them to thrive well. That is why there is need for you to remove them. They constitute nuisance. Even in our homes, we do remove the grasses that are growing up because they constitute nuisance to us as humans. So livestock also is served as what? A place where predators can hide and harm the animals, the livestock. So that's why we say they constitute nuisance to man, livestock, or crops. The next definition says, from the above definitions, it is clear that a crop plant may become a weed as long as it is growing where it is not desired. For instance, in your farm, maybe you planted maize. Along the line, you discover that there is guinea corn in that farm. That guinea corn that you have not planted has become what? A weed in that farm. There is a need for you to do what? To remove it. Then, after knowing this, we're going to look at the characteristics of weeds. This weed that we're talking about, they have characteristics. One of the characteristics of wheat is, weeds have efficient seed disposal method, either by water, either by wind, man, animals, and explosive mechanism. That's to tell you that the wheat that we're talking about, it can spread easily, unlike plants, the crops that we're planting in our farms. You know that before a plant will germinate, you must have gone there. A crop will germinate, you must have gone there with a seed to plant it. But in the case of wheat, it's not like that. It germinates easily anywhere it finds itself. So that's point one. Point two says, most wheat produce many seeds. That's the truth. Like grasses. You see that one grass can produce a lot of seeds that will propagate later, that will become a nuisance to crops or livestock. So also, wheat seeds have long period of viability, that can stay longer. than the crops we're planting. That's why you see, even if you burn a place, grasses will germinate again from that place because of what the viability of that weed in that place that will make it to do what to grow effectively in that place, because they don't have problem with adverse weather or whatsoever. Anytime they have rainfall, they germinate. Then the next point says, they have efficient means of propagation, that is by seed and vegetative. We say by seed. Most of the wheat we are seeing, they can be propagated through seeds. What do we mean by seeds? If you look at the crops we are cultivating, the parts, like most especially the grains, the cereals, the parts that you store, you eat, is the seed we are talking about. So also the plants, the wheat, have this, what we call seeds. That is from the seeds, they can be propagated, they can be reproduced, they can be replanted, so that they'll germinate and grow again. Then they have the vegetative parts. The vegetative part we're talking about is some weeds. It's not necessary that they propagate by seeds. They do asexual propagation. That is, their roots may germinate. The part of the plant may also germinate. It's one of it. Then the next point says, they are aggressive and persistent in their growth, so grow faster. That's tell you that they grow faster than the crop you have planted in that farm. They grow faster than the crop you have planted in that farm. Then the next point says, they have wide adaptation, so have modified parts, leaves, stems, roots, and seeds that help them to survive adverse environmental conditions. Yes, these weeds that we're talking about, they survive. Even if there is no water, they will try by all means to remain in that place. But in terms of crops that you have planted, if there is no water, what will happen to the crops? The crop will die. But in the case of weeds, wheat can stay there until it gets rain that will elevate it to grow and produce seeds, so that it will cause another problem to the crop you are going to plant there. Then the next point says, some weeds have short life cycle, but they have higher reproductive capacity. That the life cycle is short, but they have higher reproductive capacity. They can reproduce plenty seeds. Then the next point, some common wheat in the locality, we have Amaranthus spinosus is a leaf, a wheat that resembles Spanish, but it has thorn on it. It has thorn on its body. You can see the picture here. You are seeing as if it is Spanish, African Spanish, but it's not African Spanish, but it is a wheat that has thorn on it, even though the leaves resemble that of African Spanish. The next one is carpet grass. The carpet grass, even in your school, you can see they plant them there to decorate the school. In the farm, you can also find them. They serve as what? Wheat. They can prevent your crop from doing well. The next one is cider acuta or broom wheat. We call it cider acuta. You know the broom wheat. You can see the picture here. The broom wheat that they can cut it. Some people use it to sweep their environment with it. They tie it. It's very long. As you're moving on the road, you see them by the side of the road. They are there. They call them cider acuta. That is the botanical name. But local name, we can call it broom wheat. Then water leaf. I know some of our parents, if they are trying to prepare soup, they use this leaf to prepare soup with it. We call it water leaf. This water leaf serves as what? Wheat in a farm. It's also wheat in a farm. Uses of wheat. Despite the fact that we say wheat are having problems with our crops in the farms, they have also useful aspects of it. Then one, we say some weeds have medical value or purpose. Yes, some weeds, we use them as what? Form of medicine. We can cook it, use it whenever you are having issues in the at home. You can get this if you cannot have money for the synthesized drugs or the orthodox drugs. You can go for these herbal drugs that you can use from the weeds. You can get some that serve as that purpose. Then two, Some wheat are sources of food for man, e.g. water leaf that we have just seen. This one that we have just seen is have as well source of food to mankind, for man. So this part of it. Another one is they are sources of feed for livestock, like greeny grass. We use it to feed our goats at home, the sheep, even the cow, we move them, they can feed on them because it serves as well source of feed for livestock. And then the next point says, wheat are sources of materials for manure preparation. Sources of material for manure preparation. In our schools, they have told us about compost manure. How to prepare this compost manure? We use the wheat to make this preparation of compost manure. Or if you are in the farm cultivating, the green grasses that are just germinating, if you are covering them, they call them green manure. So it's part of what wheat that add up nutrient to the soil. So the next point says they help to control erosion. Just like in the case of carpet grass that we have earlier mentioned, we use it to control erosion. Whenever you have seen an erosion, you can carry carpet grass and plant in that place. The carpet grass can control the erosion. Then, they serve as mulching materials. Have you ever been to a yam farm? Or have you ever seen where they're raising a nursery? If you have ever seen a yam farm, you discover that after planting the yam, they'll carry leaves or grasses to put on top of the yam and then cover it with sand. That's tell you that the grass they put there is called mulching, a mulch. So that process of putting it there is the mulching we're talking about. Then you can use it in your farm. We use the wheat. We gather the wheat, put them on top of the yam. Or if you are trying to raise a nursery of tomato, pepper, cocoa, oil palms, and the rest of them. From the nursery, we'll make a shed. Use the wheat to cover the top so that to avoid excessive sun shine direct to the nursery you are trying to raise. Then, after knowing all this, you have some assignment to take to look at it. I would like you to have your writing material ready. Then, as I mean, one says, define the term wheat. Two, say, mention at least three characteristics of wheat. Then, as I mean, three says, list three examples of wheat in your locality. Thank you, and stay safe till I come your way again next time. Thank you.